especially young dogs, they love to play. They play with his brothers, they play with his sisters, yes, in his pack, in his litter. They are used to play. And you as the handler, you just have to continue that playing. Mm-hmm. If you don't play, the play drive dies. Joyce asked me to show a little bit of playing of a dog, because in my opinion it's very important. You have to play with the dog, you have to build up drive for the obedience. And if the dog has the drive for a toy, then it's easy for you to train with him, because then you can reward him, give him a gift, or let him play for a couple seconds. And yeah, this is what I try to do with her. It's a little bit. First I tease her a little bit. And it's important not give it to the dog right away. The dog has to show activity. He has to show. Yeah. If the dog comes back to you, never take right away the toy away. This builds up avoidance and the dog do not come back to you. Play again with her. If she holds on good, if she pulls, let her win.
Oh, that's a good girl.
Come here. Yeah. Good. All this drive what you build up, you can use that drive for obedience. Play rough with your dog. Dogs like a little rough play. Important is, don't give the dog the toy into his mouth. The dog has really be active. He has to go for the toy. And if the toy is hiding behind your body, the dog has to be able to go around, search. What also important is, touch your dog. Praise him, not just with the voice, touch him.
Okay, pretty girl.
Get him. Yeah. Hey, hey, hey! Needle! Needle, come! Come here! Yeah, come here! If the dog comes back to you, never go for the toy. Instantly for the toy, praise first the dog. Needle. If you want to get the toy, change the subject for the dog. Means. Offer him food. If she eats the treat, you grab for the toy. Or you have a second toy. Or offer him a different toy.
Yep. Yeah.
Did he do a healing? Good. That's fine then.
And after you have built up all these drive, you can use this for the obedience. Come here.
He likes this in particular.
Hey, if you play with your dog, it's important not to give him the toy and here you have it and play by yourself. Playing with a dog is teasing. Here, show him and take it away. And this builds up drive. This makes it interesting for him. He wants to have
shit.
Yeah, you got it. You weenie.
You can tell right away he's a working dog.
You like?
That's what Joy says about him.
He bumps in me and he forces me in. This female, what we had before, she always had a distance, not him.
Yeah.
He gets really pissed off when you hit him too.
That's good.
He does it for something.
We like that. In the police world, we love that. We love it.
Good. You can tell.
He likes to pull it too. I let him pull me back.
What is important when you play with a dog? The dog always has to be the active point. Yeah? Not you are active and hump around like a jumping jack and try to play with your dog. You have to teach him he has to go for the toy.
Oh.
If he is active, then he got his toy and then he wins it. Yeah? Give me a stinger. Leo! Come here.
There's some balls in there. Leo.
So
you're getting them with Thomas Foos right now.
Yep. It's just right. Subject for him, and I got my toy. I did not have to put pressure on him. He's still in drive, and I start the game. Not new. Not bad for a green dog.
Yeah, not bad. Harold, you're doing great too. Looking great. Harold does great.
Yeah. She's used to doing it. You know, everybody over there in front.
It doesn't matter if he jumps like that?
No. In the beginning, not. Okay. We do not train now for obedience. What we train before we train for obedience is build up drive, build up energy, motivation.
Yeah, he's having a good time with you. He likes that.
Every kid like to play. Every dog like to play. Hey. You can play a little bit tough.
Yeah, he likes to play rough.
Yeah.
He likes it when you do that. You hit him and stuff.
Good, he's
you want less air?
Yeah. Fritz, you see, it doesn't matter which toy you take,
right?
Is it a chew stick? Is it a ball? What? Ow! Whatever it is, you can take a leaf, you can take your leash. Important for the dog is you have something what he wants to have. This brings up drive. And this you use in the obedience. You tease him, you teach him force, here's your reward.
At what age, Harold, do you start?
To be honest, 3 months.
3 months?
It's not a tough play, it's an easy play. But what you teach a young dog, and especially young dogs, they love to play. They play with his brothers, they play with his sisters, in his pack, in his litter. They are used to play. And you as the handler, you just have to continue that play. If you don't play, the play drive dies.
Up a sweat here.
Okay, let's see you getting back.
Leo, come. Come, Kasper. Yeah.
You got some good prey grab, bro. You got it deep in
come
his
here. Mouth. Come on, Leo, Leo. Come on, come on. Look, look what I got.
Does that help you a little bit?
Absolutely.
And this game you can do
anywhere.
I would say 3-4 times a day if you want and if you have the time for that.
You think he has
the power or what? This dog is excellent.
Yeah. Just gonna work with
you. Have a really good dog,
I don't think you can do that.
But you have to spend time with him. You have to build up drive, and then later you can teach him to do that work. What you think you have been doing today?
When I was watching you, usually I have to
Fritz for a couple
do with
minutes.
Food.
Yeah, he doesn't know how to
get him to do anything. But now I'm realizing you don't necessarily have to do that.
No, I do
mean, it's a basis.
I do it with drive.
Yeah.
Because if you don't feed the dog constantly, he loses interest, right? But with the ball, you can always have him with a little movement of your body. You bring him back.
Yeah.
Because he thinks now the game starts again.
That was really very helpful. Thank you.
I hope so.
Carol, watch Fritz. Let's see you play and do that.
Well, you need to get some Kansas vintage in there.
Faster than I thought.
It wouldn't be a video without Kansas.
Yeah, and dogs getting fast. When they once they have that toy, they really get fast.
Me?
Give him the feeling he's the big boy. You don't
speak English.
Let him pull, let him pull.
A half, he would not let go. Shepard. Back there.
Come on. Oh, there you go. There you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
And now drop it. Drop it.
Oh, he's pulling.
And then out of it.
Hey, good boy. Good boy.
When you drop it, it's for him, he wins. You give him the feeling he's dry,
which is what he wants.
That feels up even more dry. Okay. To pull.
Oh, okay. You want a tug of war?
Dollar worth? Dollar?
Let him win again. Let him win.
Bill.
Good.
That's good. He likes
Fritz,
that.
Yeah. Don't always just in front of you. Hide it behind your body.
Okay.
Make him search for that toy.
All right.
Because later on you have the toy hidden in your pocket or under your jacket, and the dog has to look for it, search for it. Teach him the searching means hide behind your back, and the dog has to start not only stay in front of you, but look to you and wait till you offer it to him. He has to go around you.
How old is
this
one?
4 months.
Oh, I think he's a little distracted.
That's a big distraction. Good, yeah.
Okay, and when he does this 3, 4, 5 times, then let's have it.
He did.
Let him win.
Yeah.
Good. Give something to him. Don't make a fight out of it.
Just give it to him.
Yes.
And let him go. Let him win.
Good.
You did great, Leo. Dog line. Yeah. And right now I would say he's tired.
Yeah.
Now you take him back to the car, give him a rest, give him water. And I would say after 30 minutes you can repeat that play. He needs a little time to recover, and they like that type of play. This helps you for your training too. Dogs likes it, plus it helps you.
It's fun.
Yeah, it's fun, sure.
Thank you. You're welcome. I think, what are you going to use with Cobra?
I'll have to keep the tug.
Poke him, and by the way, you tell him, ouse. So he has to realize the combination. He takes me a breath, he takes me out, insects me out.
Okay.
Combination.
All right. Will do. Come on. He wants a piece of that stuff.
That's good, though.
Hey.
He is 4 months.
Mm-hmm.
have a ball.
Yeah, he screwed up.
Screwed up. She knows I have the ball.
Stuff your brawl. Stuff it.
We should have the four going. Two and two.
Stuff the brawl.
Yeah?
She laughs, mommy, which is okay, which is good. Yeah.
See what he did? He taught her to look for it.
He first like sees her a little bit, mm-hmm. and all of a sudden it's gone. Mm-hmm. And this makes her searching for it. And this is what we want to teach her. She has to go for that toy. And if she finds it, she wins. It means she can have it for a couple seconds. And then we not directly go back for the ball. We praise her. We make her happy. We show her it's a good thing what you do. You go for the ball, you find the ball. Good girl, good girl. And then when she loses a little bit of interest, it's gone. And we start again with that game. Last time when she went behind me, she was successful. Now she did it again. They try to find the dogs, try to find the ball or the toy, the treat, what they like to have. Yeah. And I distract the dog a little bit. Good. Yeah. What I always do, I try to keep the dog with me. I don't allow the dog go away and lay down and find his peace, not close to me. So I keep the dog with me and praise her. And time by time they learn not to run away, just stay there, play. And then stay there because I did not show interest for the toy. I showed my patience to the dog. And see, she's relaxed. She's not afraid I take that thing away. Because if I take it away, and she cannot see it. I distract her and it's gone. Oh, look what she did. Go for it, she looks. let her win, but I don't let her go away. I keep her, I praise her, grab the collar, and she stays, you know, she relaxed and she lay down. I can't distract her again. Sit away. So I never take something directly away from her, and she learns to get avoidance.
Avoidance behavior from you. Yeah.
If you threw something far away,
I mean, it's still there,
the dog first he chases it. And in that moment when he picks it up far away from you, then he has his reward. But not from you, somewhere down in the field. If you want to reward your dog, you have to do it, not when you threw it away, and he rewards himself somewhere in the field. If he wants to reward your dog, then you gave it out of your hand. And this teasing, you can start first on the ground, and later on you can step up. Can do it in movements, like I show it to Fritz. You can walk back and forth a couple paces, and always hide the toy a little bit, so it makes its built-up drive to follow you. A normal reaction. She cannot have it right away, so she goes for something else.
You say the word you want Harold to follow him to or not?
I do what?
Like if you tell him poop or whatever, do you say that?
In that age, I don't tell her poop because she don't know what is meat. I just guide it in the beginning with the toy, and later on, if she walks pretty nice with me, then I start with this command foos. And by the way, she learns walk on my left side means foos.
calling here, and that the toy is hidden, and he comes for your ear, for your comment, then you reward him with the toy. It should be a surprise for him.
Okay.
Yeah. Right now, he does it just for the toy, not for you, or because you call him here. No, right now he does it just for the toy. But this is your job as a handler, to teach him something. Means you hide that thing and you call him, here, come, here. Without that. Not without, hidden with that.
No, we didn't go, toy. We didn't go.
And if he comes because you call him, not that thing calls him, you call him, then you reward him with that. Does it make sense to you what I tried?
It does, but I have another question. Okay, so we're teasing the dog, and the dog's building up drive. But I'm still having trouble with how I get from there to starting to move towards having the dog walk at your side. Some of these other things.
Thank
I'm not sure how I get to that. Now, I mean, obviously, right now I got to build up drive, but
right.
What do I do then?
That was like
the
a year after that.
You build up drive.
Yeah.
And when you have that drive for the toy, you just put the toy here under your arm. What happens next? The dog is here, jumps up, wants to have that thing. When you have the leash on your dog and you correct him, you teach him with this little pups, you teach him where is his position. Not in front of you, not behind you. Come. There is the position where he wants to have him. And if he is in a perfect position, you reward your dog with the toy. It means, well, he can have it.
Just to go to the bathroom, and I'm already down a case of beer.
Come on. Okay, so then the next thing is, okay, so we're getting the dog to walk with you. Do you use pinch collars much?
Sure.
You do?
Sure.
Okay. And should I always just be using that kind of collar that I was using? It's pretty loose.
To be honest, your dog will tell you why. You will feel, and your dog tells you that if you need a pinch or not.
Okay.
If you are no more able to handle your dog on a regular collar, pinch.
When I run with him, I don't want to pinch just because I don't want to yank him.
You like to control him.
Yes, I have.
And it's the same if you go for a walk. You like to have a nice, easy dog on a loose leash.
Right.
And if he pulls you around, it's not fun for you. So, put a pinch on him.
We do, we
teach you to walk normal. Teach you. A dog is like a kid. They have to learn their behavior.
Okay, so going a step further, okay, you talked to me a little bit about walking. What about fox and how do I mean, right now it's strictly food. That's the way I'm bringing them out here, you know, with the food. That's the only way I'm getting him to do it, and even then he's kind of
I teach my dog. I just go down on my knees. I have food in my hand. And I call him in, use my hand. And I tell him, plots. With the left hand, I control him. I hit him a little bit on the shoulder. I make him go in his down. And in this moment, and I always tell him, plots. Plots. I make him go down. And in that moment, when he is in his down, my hand goes open and he gets his feet.
So you have to do it primarily with food. You can't do
sure.
it with a toy or anything.
No.
You cannot. All right.
Because the toy is drive, is action, is motivation. And when we teach a dog down, he has to be calm. He has to be relaxed.
That was a big old
one. You called it.
No, Andy actually said. I thought so, but I thought she was looking for whatever fell out of that tree, and then he said, I think she's got to go.
Okay, and is there anything else? Okay, there's the walking, there's the... Okay, so it's starting to fall into place.
For sure, and I would say we stop now because I think I'm making us confused. You have a
Well, that was very helpful, though. I just gotta work with it.
Good girl, pick it up! Come on.
Tease him, play. Yeah. Not just teasing, is something here, but she never can have it, or he never can have it. Play means...
The puppy gets that one!
Yeah, build up drive. That's fun for everybody.
Yeah, he likes it, obviously. Yeah.
He really likes being inflamed.
Yes, he does.
Yay!
Well, thank you, man.
You're welcome.